People smile and tell me I'm the lucky one.
The veil that I'm wearing today is a very special veil that my mother wore, as well as my Aunt Margie and all their cousins. It was a gift from their parents' good friend, Aunt Bernice. I remember seeing it for the first time in person at my cousin Julie's wedding, and thinking how special it is that, you know, we can all share that veil, and after the end of wearing it, you get to sew your name into the bottom of it in the small lace around the edges. And I'm just overjoyed to be able to put my name next to my mom's, or nearby anyway. Tom and I met living in the dorms of White Pine here at UNR.
Her roommate was actually dating one of my roommates at the time. And then I think she came down and asked one of my roommates some homework questions, and we just kind of started hanging out from there.
I went downstairs to talk to one of his roommates. I was tutoring his roommate and one of his groomsmen, Joey, in English, and he was helping me out in math because I was sad in math. And I ended up doing an interview with Tom, asking him about Harley-Davidson's, and was surprised to kind of meet him and find out that he had all the answers I was looking for. And little did I know that that was the beginning of something else. So,
but went on a couple double dates with one of my roommates and haven't looked back since. See, there's two versions of our unofficial date where I picked her up at her parents' house in Vegas, and we went out to the Cheesecake Factory at one of the casinos down in Vegas.
He showed up to my house. He picked me up at my house in Las Vegas. We went down to the Cheesecake Factory at the Forum Shops in Vegas and met up with a bunch of friends. And actually drove him by my best friend's house, my matron of honor, Monica. We drove by her house and kind of got the approval from her and went down to the mall and kind of walked around there until we met up with everybody else.
Yeah, we're gonna fly to the sun. And even though we ain't got money, I'm so in love with honey.
Had her close her eyes, kind of a ritual we do during Christmas gift giving and whatnot. And then I got down on one knee and asked her to marry me.
It was the most intense moment he got. I could hear, like, I could feel his presence getting closer, and then I could kind of feel his breathing, and I could hear everything. And he got down on his knee and he said, "Okay, you can open them." And I just kept saying, "Oh my gosh, oh my gosh." And I could barely say yes. And I think I finally uttered yes.
Lover, and she'll bring you love. And if you find she helps your man, buddy, take her home. Yeah, don't you live alone. Try to earn what lovers own. And even though we ain't got money, I'm so in love with you, honey. Everything will bring a change.
He is just so willing to help others, and you know, he's there for his friends. He's there for his family. Family's so important to him. And I just, there's so many values that he has that I just, you know, really appreciate. And, you know, I want to make a part of my life.
Intelligent, full energy, you know, something a little different. You know, I don't know how else to describe it, but
he's amazing. That, I'm emotional, sorry. That he's, you know, tall, tan, and handsome, and, you know, everything that I never knew I needed.